And Avery.
Call the special meeting of the Amory City Council for Wednesday, March 27th, 2024. Roll call.
Marks
here.
Ben Summerin
here.
Thompson
here.
Ben Blackham
here.
Elkin
here.
Flannel
here.
Manor
here.
Okay. And I think since this is a special one, we still should probably stand and do the
sure.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. We only have one item on the agenda for the special council meeting. Patty.
Yeah. So Sarah had asked if I put together some interest rates, and I did that. And basically, the amount that I have at the top of your page is what the radios cost. And then we have a down payment in the amount of $18,348. And then the cost of the radios are $88,000. And then I've got one quote from DSC Communications. And basically, if we order before April 6th, the interest rates are as follows: 3 years, 6.31%; 5 years, 6.6%; 7 years, 5.93%. And then the wait time for the radios is 20 to 40 weeks.
Pardon?
20 to 40 weeks. Mm-hmm. And then Eric Murphy, or Humphrey, I'm sorry, the sales for DSG advised that he would check into that to see if the radios are getting sent out faster than that. So, and then if we sign on again by 4/6/2024, then the first payment would not be due until 4/6/2025. If the city were to find other financing, the price will not change as the price is the state rate price. So, and then I went to Bremer Bank and they offered for 3 years, 5.81%. 5 years, 5.91%, and 7 years, 6%. And it basically said if we're to proceed, the city would need to have city council authorization for the borrowing, much like we've done in the past with the minutes. And we would need to engage their attorney to review the documents. So that would take probably a month or so. And then this, like I said, could take a month or more. They also had another thought, given the nature of the request, we could explore a revolving line of credit, and that would allow us to move more quickly on purchases like this, rather than having to open separate loans for each acquisition. So line of credits would likely be 1% higher than the borrow. So when I read the 5.81, it would be 6.81. 5.91, 6.91, and 6 would be 7. But then if a situation like this were to arise, we could already have the facility in place. So, and that's immediate. We get that done right away. And then I went through Board of Commissioners, public lands, and their interest rates are across the board 6%. So 3 years is 6, 5 is 6, and 7 is 6. Turnaround time is usually 1 month after a borrowing resolution is shown and it's approved by the council. So that's the three options I looked at. And you also in your packet have what we've been looking at. So, and I don't know if anyone wants to weigh in with anything.
Pretty much it.
Thank you for taking the time to do that. I appreciate it. I mean, it's good information because you never know if we can get better financing locally or through other avenues. So, we were intending on doing 7 years. Am I correct?
Not in this one.
I thought we were.
Because this is they a were smaller amount.
But their value was, or the contract was going to be for 7 years originally.
Well, I think that was financing through them.
This DSC is them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Right. So yeah.
Well, just so you know, that number that you have now for the interest rate is back to the original interest rate, because once I called up there and asked them about why it changed, they got it back to the original.
So is it higher or lower?
It's lower. The other one was like for 7 years was seven something percent. Mm-hmm. It was really strange because it like flip-flopped the whole interest rate around.
Well, and I thought we were talking about 7 years originally because the life of these radios is like
seven years.
Mm-hmm. So we were going to finance them for that period of time, I thought. Is that not the case?
No, I think you're correct. I just think if we can pay it off sooner, and may, you know, we're always using borrowed funds, but you know, if you got a lower interest rate, I think that's
not going to be lower if we go 7 years with DSC, the contract is with. It's going to be
right. Mm-hmm. But I'm interested in that line of credit. You know,
mm-hmm.
that's all.
So the benefit of doing DSC is that we can place the order immediately. Is that correct? Versus if we go with outside financing, we have to wait for the financing to be in place.
Well, not necessarily, because they're talking 20 to 40 weeks of.
That's network. The wait time for
yeah.
the.
Just to, yeah.
We already know that.
It's right.
When the order's placed.
Yes.
Which is
immediate.
Six.
Yeah.
To get that finance
yeah.
rate. How many departments in Polk County have this capability?
St. Croix Falls, Polk County, Sheriff's Department. I think Osceola is also running the 800 megahertz radios through Motorola. A lot of the smaller departments, I don't know, but I think almost everybody's Motorola. No, I don't mean.
But specifically this type of, I think you're probably right. Everybody's got Motorola pretty much, but specifically the
800 megahertz one.
The one that's sorry about that. Showing my age. specifically, so St. Croix Falls is the only one that you're sure of that has that.
Yeah.
But it doesn't, and this does not affect, we still have all the communications with all the cars. And
we, right now, we don't, because of the encryption, we don't have their encryption capability.
I know, but they don't have to talk in encryption. Is that correct?
They do.
Is that correct?
Yeah.
So county still has, we still can communicate with everybody in the county, just not encrypted.
Right. And that's where the issue comes up.
Okay.
Once they switch to encryption.
And so would you reiterate what the value of encryption is to our department?
To our department is, just to go back to the last couple incidents that we had, once the county switches to encryption, our radios don't hear anything. The only way, you might once in a while hear a little bit of a click, but then you got to look down and you see that there's a light on and there's no communication at all. Our portable is the same thing, but we don't even get a click on our portable. So if they go to encrypted, we don't even know that they're unencrypted unless somebody that's not unencrypted would hop on and say something. So
correct me if I'm wrong. So if the county has a call for you to go on, they still are able to communicate with you and it doesn't.
Right. It doesn't affect the radio.
And you can talk to them regardless.
Right. But if they go to encryption, then we can't.
And that would be when?
A lot of
generally,
times it's an emergency, something that they don't want over the radio.
Most everything you do is an emergency,
right? But they had the homicide down in Osceola. Jim couldn't hear any of the conversation that was going on, and they didn't even know where the guy was at. So Jim had no clue if the guy was coming this way or not. We had an incident south of town here where the county went into encrypted. None of our guys knew what was going on. We had a guy up by Frederick that was out in the woods with a rifle threatening to shoot cops. Me and Kip were working that day. We had no clue what was going on. So, I mean, it's.
However, the county still had the ability to. Why didn't they? Because they know that only at this point, Osceola.
They don't have no choice. When they switch to it, there's nothing we can do besides hope that.
So, are you saying that they're not going to. They're not going to call you on the radios that we have existing, or?
Well, they'll call us, but if we're heading to a call that's an emergency and they're on encrypted and we're heading up there, we're not getting the information because we don't hear nothing. So if we're being mutual aided to go and assist them, they're on encrypted, we don't know what's going on because we can't hear it. So we're kind of going in blind. And that's why we want to get the encryption so we're not going into situations like that.
Dan, are other departments around the county going in this direction? Do you know?
Yes, they're, because if the state changes their frequency to the 800 megahertz, every department throughout the state will have to switch to the 800 megahertz radios. There won't be no questions about it. It's going to come down, and once they do that, because Minnesota went to it, or just Wisconsin's a little bit behind, and I know they keep bringing it up at legislature to push it. That if that happens, you're not going to have any choice other than to switch to the 800 megahertz band.
And is there rumors out there that the state is going to switch to that?
Yep.
Any idea on a time frame?
They've been talking it since Minnesota went to it, which was like 5 years ago. They've been talking about switching over to it. I haven't heard when they're planning on doing it, but I know there's a big push for it, especially the southern big departments are pushing harder and harder to go, because what the 800 megahertz allows you to do is the radios have enough capability that they can actually put in every department throughout the state on your radio. So if you ever get shipped somewhere else, all you got to do is tune your radio to their channel and you can communicate with them. But right now, because of the way it is, we don't have everybody's frequencies and everybody's radio communication. We do have several, but we don't have all of them. So that's the other thing about the 800 megahertz, is that they can load in all the frequencies, from my understanding, throughout the state, and you can communicate. No matter where you go, you can communicate on the radio with those.
So if the state decrees that, are they going to take your squad car away if you don't have it? Or what?
What's the radio system? You're because that once you go to the 800 megahertz, these won't work. They won't work at all. We can't communicate with Minnesota at all because our radios are in 800 megahertz, so we can't even communicate with them.
Currently.
What's that?
Currently,
yeah.
But you still do have point to point and
with Minnesota? No. They have to do a whole patch thing through the county if they want to try to get it to work. And that doesn't always work.
They don't care about us anymore?
Minnesota?
Yeah.
I don't know. It's very infrequent that we even do the patch anymore unless it's like a high-speed chase that's a homicide or something. Then they'll do the patch because the patch takes a while to
steps
to get that to hook up.
What's the upside or downside if we didn't do this until budget time in the fall?
Other than the financing.
That's basically the
because we're time, right?
Pardon?
And the lead time on the technology.
Yeah. The longer we wait, the further it is. So if you wait till budget time, you're going 40 weeks after that. You're into the following year, way into the next year. So,
but if we go with DSC, there is no payment until next April. So right. We'll down, be in the budget.
Down payment. You still have to have a down payment, right?
No, we could have did zero. Mm-hmm. But we elected that we had $18,000 from the state.
Okay. Which
I picked up and stuff.
Okay.
Well, financially, two months ago, we added $26,000 to Dan's budget. Last month, we approved a sixth officer, which adds $60,000 or more. And now we're talking about adding $18,000. So, just we have to figure out where that money is going to come from, which area, mm-hmm. You know.
I thought, didn't you just say that there's money dog-eared for the down payment this year?
Yeah, just for the down payment. Yeah,
correct. And so the rest of the payments wouldn't actually start until next year.
Correct.
That's correct.
So, but
so it could be part of budget
next year.
So
So we have to have that extra money into the budget for next year.
Right.
Coming up this
How does that affect our fiscal constraint from the state?
It's going to depend on how it shakes out. We don't know what we're allowed to increase by yet, or I don't, at least. I don't think it's out yet. So it's going to depend on what we're restrained by for next year and how much we can actually add to the overall budget. So, yes, you can say you're going to budget for it, but I do not know what you're actually going to have for an increase.
What's been typical, do you know?
Off the top of my head.
My understanding is that your radios are already getting to the point where they're obsolete. Is that correct?
Yep.
So you're going to need to replace them sometime soon.
Yeah, I'm also concerned if you wait that long, how much of a price increase is there? Not
mm-hmm.
not financing, but stuff doesn't get cheaper.
Yep. Right.
And
especially Motorola stuff.
Our radios the batteries are starting now. Go up pretty quick. I mean, you can charge them up, but they're not lasting very long before you get a switch out of battery. So,
and what's the age limit age right now of the current radios that we have?
I think we're at 7 or 8 years, if I remember right, when they were purchased.
That's pretty typical for portables.
Mm-hmm. That's pretty good. I think we're on our least second batch of batteries right now. So they're starting to fail. So,
the concern that I would have then is, if the state suddenly decides that they're going to go the 800 megahertz and everybody in the state is forced to go in that direction, what is our wait time going to look like?
Probably longer.
Well, if everybody has to go, yes. If there's a demand immediately.
In my mind, we have to replace them because they're starting to have issues.
Mm-hmm.
We need to replace them with the most current technology. I think it makes sense to move forward now. It sounds like you guys have figured out the financial piece of it. So.
Well, the other question that I have, when you talk about obsolete or antiquated systems, we're looking at 7 years. We're talking about a system right now that's 7 or 8 years old, and it's pretty much useless when you go future-wise.
Right.
Where if we finance for 7 years, we could potentially still be paying $19,000 annually for a system that is barely hanging on technology-wise. Would we be better off to finance it for a shorter period so that we're not paying for a system that we're going to throw out next week?
Yeah, and I think that's what Roger brought up as well, because technology doesn't just, you know, there's not just a cycle of things improving, but overall battery life will improve over that period of time. So it would be better if we weren't stuck paying for something for 7 years, because think about 7 years ago, what technology was available in your pocket,
right,
your phone. So I would have trouble with a 7 year also.
Well, I would be all about the option number two, the 5 year.
Evidently, you didn't like that one.
Are you, which avenue of financing are you thinking with 5 year? Are you thinking going with the DSC, because then we can forego the payment, or?
I think so. And I mean, if we want to set up a line of credit for future programs or, you know, things that we have to buy down the road, we could establish a line of credit for future use as needed. But I think for right now, financing through them would be advantageous. So I would make a motion that we go with the 5 year payment plans
through DSC.
through DSC. I was getting there. I couldn't get the right initials.
I had it in front of me.
I'll second that.
Okay, motion's made and seconded to proceed with the five-year plan for replacing the radios. Is there any other discussion? Call a question by roll call.
Marks?
Yes.
Van Someren?
Yes.
Thompson?
Yes.
Elkin?
Yes.
Flannel?
Yes.
Manor?
Yes.
So approved. Motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
I'll second.
Motion made and seconded that the special council meeting be adjourned. All in favor say aye.
Aye. Aye.